mode crack propagation during needle penetration from surgical interventions. So I would like to acknowledge my co-authors, Professor Daniele Dini from Imperial College, who has been working a lot on this field, and Michele Terzano, who is a PhD student of mine, and he has spent some time in London studying this problem, and he is really the one who has done most of his simulations, and it has been a strong link between my institution and Imperial College. So, as you have noticed from the title, we are talking about a problem related to some clinical need and to surgical operations. So there are, of course, many fields and experience needed to tackle this problem, but there are also some issues related to solid mechanics, which has to be understood. The specific problem that we investigated is needle steering. So there are clinical situation during surgical operation where the operator needs to drive the needle along specific trajectories. And the type of needle that I'm going to show you is based on some biological inspiration, and so there are some aspects related very much to robotics and mechatronics, and so are out of my field of interest, but still are very important in the overall view of the research. What I'm concentrating here is about system modeling, and because there is this object which is penetrating in a tissue, biological tissue, there are some interesting processes to be well understand in order to make a proper simulation of the physical problem. So there is an insertion process, there is a complex coupling between the tool, the penetrating tool, and the tissue. So there are interactions between the two objects, and there is a specific aspect related to the fracture of the tissue, which is under, as I will show you later on, under mixed model loading. And of course there is a need for needle control, and this is very much related to the control of the trajectory that the needle has to follow. So then I will show some results and conclusions on the work. So just to put it in a general frame, there is a need in surgical operations which is moving in the past decades from open surgery, which is a conventional surgery process, to minimal invasive surgery techniques. And because the project which we were involved on is very much related to brain surgery operations, so I'm showing here some specific issues related to that organ. So the question which was arised is to describe curved paths through the brain. So basically we have to go from a point A where the needle is inserted to a target point B, but we need to, for some clinical reasons, we have to follow some curved path. So this is an issue that has been tackled in the research of needle steering, and here I'm very briefly summarized different techniques back in the beginning of the 2000s, and we started with some authors started with needle steering using lateral motion of the sternal base. So here there are listed, I'm not going through the details, but there are listed advantages and disadvantages of this first technique, which is the oldest. And then there is a technique related to a bevel tip, of a needle, which creates some axisymmetric contact traction, and according to this axisymmetric contact traction, we have a bending of the needle, which allows to create some curvature. But because this bevel tip geometry is fixed, there are some limitations in the control of the curvatures of the trajectories which are followed by the needle. Another technique that has been proposed is active cannulas. So they are basically concentric tubes which are in a kind of a telescopic fashion extending, but this has the limitation of having prescribed trajectories. What we consider here is actually something that, because it's nice to say so, is inspired from nature, and is actually a programmable flexible needle, which is composed, so the inspiration is from this insect which are of a positor, they have an ovipositor organ, and this is made by a number of sectors which are moving one respect to the other, and so this is the inspiring idea of a needle that was developed by a group at Imperial College. And because of this relative movement between the segments composing the needle, we can actually have a very important feature, which is having a variable steering offset. So this variable steering offset is the tool to have a control in the radius of curvature of the trajectory followed by the needle during penetration in the target tissue. So here is just a sketch of the working system, and there are some important aspects to highlight, which are the resistive forces, which are traction contact forces between the needle and the tissue, which have some axisymmetric features. And this creates a bending of the needle tip. Okay, so this is just an highlight of some experimental results, which as most of the results, experimental results performed are related to soft tissue phantom. So we use gelatins to which have some consistent mechanical properties with the biological tissues to perform experiments. And so here we have a variety of curvatures changing the offset value. And so you have a curvature in one direction or in the other direction. This case is actually with no offset. But anyhow, it's the task is to simulate this experimentally observed behavior. So we have worked so far with a 2D finite element model, and the aim, as I already mentioned, is to describe the penetration process of a flexible needle, and up to now we are considering a constant offset, and the penetration is into a soft material. So the main issues involved are listed here. So there is a frictional contact between the two objects, there is a fracture process going on at the tip of the needle, and we have cast this process within the framework of a cohesive model. And because of the axisymmetric features of the needle, there are issues related to mixed mode fracture propagation, along, of course, non-predefined paths. the force, one of the key overall response that we want to investigate is the force versus needle penetration, and this is a typical diagram which is obtained during the penetration process, and of course in this phenomenon different energy contribution are involved, and they involve strain energy, energy dissipation by friction, and fracture energy during the formation of new surfaces. So this is a description, detailed description of a needle. So there are some key geometrical parameters. C is the offset length, alpha is the angle of opening of the tip, rho tip is the radius of curvature of the tip, and we are interested at simulating and determining the radius of curvature of this needle during the penetration. Or in other way, we can look at the rotation angle at the tip. So because of time and because it's late, I don't have much time to go into the details, but the problem is tricky from a numerical point of view. Well, I mean, we are working within the framework of finite element method, so we are not developing new techniques, but still there are some critical issues related to the high deformability of the tissue and also the needle itself. What we have done, we have a simple linear cohesive crab model used for opening and sliding displacements, which of course have, because of the numerical implementation, have some stiffness in the elastic range, which is not infinite, and this gives additional compliance length in the opening. Well, I will skip most of the details, but anyhow, there is an important issue related to the fact that during, this is a rosette of the elements near the tip of the crack, during the penetration of the needle, we have to implement a cracking criterion. We use this old minimum strain energy density criterion. And so looking at the strain energy field near the crack tip, we are able at each step to determine the direction of the crack propagation. All the process is cast in an iterative algorithm, and we are working with Abacus and MATLAB. This is the flow chart of the algorithm. There are a series of issues, but anyhow, we have to update. There is an adaptive procedure which requires to remesh from step to step the tissue. The needle has to move within a rigid surface to avoid bucking of the needle, because the needle is quite flexible. We are using very simple triangular plane strain elements, and we have cohesive elements which are added time to time, depending on the direction determined by the mixed mode criterion, along the crack surface. Okay, these are some specific aspects related to the very initial phase to start to drive the initiation of the cut. We have an initial kind of notch. This is the, by the way, the shape of the needle in case of zero offset, and this is the shape of the needle when we have a non-zero offset, so is a programmable bevel needle. And this is the some details of the updating during the current stage of needle penetration. There are quite a few aspects which are important to be considered, and considering also the fact that, that of course the load is applied at the crack tip due to the interaction with the needle, which basically is producing some displacement on the crack faces. So these are some results in terms of reaction force versus needle penetration, just to get an idea of the materials we are working on. Up to now we are using a linear elastic nearly incompressible material, but we are running of course a geometrically non-linear analysis, large displacement, large deformation, and the Young modulus of gelatin material, which is a phantom tissue material, is about 15 kilopascal, so it's very deformable, and the fracture energy is this, which was determined by performing wire cutting test, which is another important issue of this soft material, is the determination of the toughness, which is not so straightforward. The needle has a diameter of 8 millimeter. The tip radius is 0.5 millimeter, the bevel angle is 20 degrees. And the Young modulus of the needle is in the range from 100 to about 1000 kilopascal. So it's itself very deformable, and of course we have assumed a Coulomb, very simple as possible, Coulomb friction with a coefficient of 0.3. So, for comparison, it is interesting to show the curve for a zero offset, and this is the curve for a 32 millimeter offset. So there are different stages in the curves, depending on the level of penetration of the needle in the tissue. So this is just an animation, but give you a good idea of what is going on in the simulation. This is the case of a symmetric needle. We don't have any prescribed path, but the algorithm is such that the needle goes vertically. Whereas this is the result for a 32 millimeter offset. There is no prescribed path, but the needle follows a curved path in the direction that we expected. Okay. So, of course, we have done a kind of parametric study varying the key parameters. Basically, there are two key parameters. One is the ratio between the rigidity of the needle and the gel, and this is the results in terms of force displacement, and this is the results varying the offset angle. There is not much, so much difference in the peak force, which is an important parameter to monitor, not as much as the variation of the rigidity. But what is more interesting is to look at the penetration trajectories. So this gives you basically these penetration trajectories varying the rigidity between needle and tissue, and varying the offset, needle offset. So this is C equals zero, is vertical trajectory, and here we have curved trajectory, and we have a variation of the curvature actually depending on the different stage in the penetration. So this is the initial stage where the tip of the needle is penetrating, and then this is the final stage where also the larger part of the needle, which is called shaft, is penetrating into the tissue. So varying the parameters, it's interesting to show the curvature. So actually by fitting the trajectory with a circle, basically, so considering a constant curvature, By fitting the trajectory, we can have a curvature varying with the relative penetration displacement. If we take the curvature at this depth, which is twice the offset dimension, we have an interesting trend in the curvature with respect to the rigidity ratio, and also which is very well linear. And also there is a linear trend, but in the opposite direction, of the curvature increasing with the offset, which is, was well expected, and it was also found by other research and also by experimental results. So to conclude, we have performed numerical simulation of this penetration problem of a flexible needle in a gelatin phantom tissue. There are other, of course, works in the literature available, but there are some of them dealing with the problem looking from the needle point of view, so it's treating the needle as a kind of cantilever beam with prescribed forces coming from the interaction with the needle. And there are some simplified models like the one we have proposed, but not as much about the fully adaptive tool, which is really able to track complex trajectories. So I think it's a promising tool. And of course, to have a precise comparison with experiments, it's very important to have good description of the mechanical parameters of the tissue materials in terms of deformability and fracture energy. And of course, now we are working on the hyperelastic constitutive models and also on viscoelasticity and also poroelasticity, which are of importance, but of course, step by step. Thank you for your attention.